أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالته الرسول المصدد المصطفى الأمجد المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال العسكري عليه السلام نحن حجج الله نحن حجج الله وفاطمة حجة علينا صلوا على محمد وآل محمد In a short period of time to speak about this holy lady is injustice. Very hard, very difficult. It's injustice for the followers of Fatima. Who can speak about Fatima? And who is Fatima? If you ask Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, he says that from the definitions of Fatima, one of the meaning of Fatima is, Imam Sadiq says, that ordinary people cannot comprehend Fatima. They cannot comprehend and understand the status of Fatima. This is from the meanings of Fatima. There are other meanings, but I've left other meanings. If we sit and discuss about the rewards of reciting tasbih of Fatima, if this cannot be described, the rewards of reciting tasbih of Fatima, that our sixth holy imam says the rewards, it is so rewarding that the rewards of reciting tasbih of Fatima after wajib salah is better than reciting 1,000 rakat of prayers. If we move forward and discuss about Fatima, then if we ask Imam Khomeini, rahimallahu alayh, you know, tonight, the 20th night of Jamadi al Thaani, or Jamadi al Akhar, if you like, it is also the birth anniversary of Imam Khomeini, rahimallahu alayh. He shares the same birthday with Bibi Fatima alayha salam. It is said that Imam Khomeini is quoted to have said that Fatima nabi mibud, agar zan nabud. When Imam Khomeini did his research, then he comes up with this conclusion. He concludes after doing research on Bibi Fatima alayhi salam. He says that Fatima would have been a prophet if she would have not been a female. From her titles, one of the titles of Fatima is Haniya, which means a personality who is compassionate with her family members. That is what it means, Haniya. Allama Majlis also brings in Bihar, in Fatima the Gracious. It's an English book. It's about Bibi Fatima. There also it is reported from our ulamas that from her names, from her titles, one of her titles is Haniya. The one who is very compassionate, very loving to her family members. Islam has given preference and significance, importance, to strengthen relations with your family members. To that extent, that if you strengthen relation with your family members, you will reach paradise. In Jannah, when you reach Jannah, we mentioned this before, that in Jannah, there is no any other work to perform in Jannah. There's no to pay bills. You don't have to pay bills there. You don't have to look a girl for your son. You don't have to look a boy or a handsome boy for your daughter. There you don't have to do any other work. There's no work, not to earn money. Jannah is nothing. according to Imam Ali alayhi salam, he says, Imam Ali alayhi salam says, Jannah is nothing but it is the place where you are rewarded. You get jaza, Imam Ali alayhi salam says. So in Jannah, people will be speaking to each other while they will be leaning on the cushions. The way Quran says that la lagwan wa la ta'thima illa qilan salaman salama. There's only peace in Jannah. But then there people will start to discuss and they will be asking. This is in Surah Tur, chapter number 52, verse number 26. That when people will start asking each other, yatasa'alun ahla bahisht, ahla Jannah, the people of paradise will be asking each other that how did you reach in Jannah? They will say that lana fi mushfiqin, fi ahlina mushfiqin, which means that we, with our family members, we were compassionate. We were loving with each other. We had that good relations with our family members. We had shafaqa, mushfiqin, fi ahlina mushfiqin, because we were in good terms with them. See, in Quran, in Surah Rum, in Maah Ramadan, on the 23rd night of Maah Ramadan, we recite three surahs. Surah Ankabut, Surah Rum, and Surah Dukhan. In Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse number 20 to 25. From verse number 20 to 25, every verse, these five verses, starts with وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, which means from his signs, from his signs. Verse number 21, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لِآيَاتٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Quran says that amongst his signs, from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his signs is that he created soulmates for you. He creates spouses for you. Why? So that you dwell happiness from them. So that you get tranquility and peace from your spouses. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And there is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who reflect and who think. It is very important to strengthen family relations. Life is all about priorities. It's all about what you give priority to. What is your priority? What is your preference? We need to give priority and preference to our family members. And this will make us reach paradise. The people of paradise will be asking each other, how did you reach here? They will say that we what did we do? Fi ahlina mushfiqin. We had shafaqa with our family members. We were compassionate with our family members. And if you, again, see, many a times, we give preference and priority to this world. Even when a proposal comes, what happens? Rasulullah tells us, what does he say? Rasulullah says that see two things when a proposal comes or when you look for a girl. See two things. What are those two things? The two things are dinuhu wa khulquhu. See his religion and see his ethics, his etiquettes. If these two things are there, give your daughter for marriage or take that girl for marriage, according to Rasulullah. Dinuhu wa khulquhu. And if you come to see the life of Zahra, we want to see the life of Bibi Zahra alayha salam, her family life, the life of Ali and Fatima. How did they spend their life? Mehwar is Zahra alayha salam. We want to draw some lessons from the life of Ali and Zahra. That how did they spend their life? The first thing which we can find from the life of Ali and Zahra is spirituality. They strengthened spirituality. Spirituality, manaviyat. They strengthen spirituality. What is spirituality? In short, in brief, spirituality means to act and implement upon wajibat and to stay away from all those things which are forbidden and prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As simple as that. This is spirituality. The first night, the time when Zahra reaches at the house of Amirul Mu'minin, what does she do? She makes for herself a mihrab. A mihrab. What is a mihrab? A prayer place. It is so good that many a times when you go to the houses of Mu'minin, there is a room special dedicated for prayers. We recite majlis there. We pray there. Yeah, maybe this is the sunnah of Zahra, to have azakhana at your home. Zahra and Marziya, the first night when she enters the house of Amirul Mu'minin, she makes a mihrab for herself. And then she says, oh Ali, this is spirituality. This is spirituality. And it does not start when you have delivered a child, oh my sisters. No, it starts when you, even others say 20 years before your marriage. Upbringing starts at that time. When she reaches at the house of Amirul Mu'minin, the first night she says to Amirul Mu'minin, she says that Nusalli hadhihi al-layla wa na'budu Allah fi hadhihi al-layla. Oh Ali, together let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and let us worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tonight, on the wedding night. It's all about which kind of spouse you have chosen. If we go for material things, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf also comes to Rasulullah and he says, Ya Rasulullah, I have brought proposal for Zahra, for your daughter. Some people don't understand. Some people think that they will attract and tempt Rasulullah with material things. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf brings 10,000 dirhams. At that time, 10,000 dirhams was amount of money. This is the mahar, this is the dowry for Zahra. I want to get married with Zahra. And this is 10,000 dirhams. Rasulullah said, take your money with you. Then Rasulullah picks some pebbles in his blessed hands. He shakes those pebbles. And those pebbles transforms to jewels and pearls and gold. Rasulullah says, what did you think, O Abdul Rahman? Only Musa can do mu'jiza? If it was for money, for material things, then here is material things. But it is not for money. And when Rasulullah said to Zahra, that, O Zahra, Amirul Mu'minin has brought proposal. What does Zahra say? Zahra says, Aradhi Allah wa Rasulah? Is Allah happy and pleased and his prophet is pleased if I get married to Amirul Mu'minin? This is the question which Zahra is posing to her father. That, O father, will Allah be pleased with me if I marry Amirul Mu'minin? This is all about priority. You give priority to spirituality. You give priority to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, when we say that the first night when Zahra enters the house of Amirul Mu'minin, she says that I'm making a mihrab for myself. And that was a mihrab that Zahra, that night, she spent in ibadah. She says, oh Ali, let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let us remember our great. Let us remember Akhirah. This is spirituality. When we say that Zahra made for herself a mihrab, yeah, at her home, and we also need to make a mihrab, that mihrab, if we are the followers of Zahra, yeah, so we go home, we make a special place for ourselves. Zahra used to pray at that place. And when she would stand in her mihrab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would tell the angels that, O angels, look at my servant Zahra. And she was named Zahra because Zahra Noor, min al ardh fis sama, a light that Noor, Zahra means the splendid one. Light would be evident, special light would be evident. It would come out from the earth, from the house of Zahra, and it would go to the heavens. And that Noor would shine over the angels of the heavens, the way the stars shine for the people of the earth. And that is why she was called Zahra. Now you might tell me, Maulana, if we make for ourselves a mihrab, you know, many a times what happens, that when we want to buy a house in mortgage, or if we go to look for a house for rent, whatever, the first thing is that, lending moto ho joye. Mulana, which house was that? It didn't have a dining hall. But she khasu kya? It doesn't mean that a person should not have a spacious house. Imam Sadiq says, min sa'adatil mar'e al maskanatul wasi'a. This is the hadith of Imam Sadiq. From the prosperity of man, it is him, for him to have a spacious house. But at the same time, if you look for a spacious house, that's fine. But do not forget akhirah also. In that spacious house, make a mihrab for yourself so that you pray and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the sunnah of Zahra. Unfortunately, this is the narration from my ustad. It didn't happen here in Iran. My ustad says that once I happened to go and visit my relatives. And they were newly wed couple, newly married. So I went to visit them. Soon it was time for salah. So I performed wudu and I asked them if I could pray at their house. And then obviously when a person wants to pray at your relative's home, you wouldn't know where the Qibla is. So he says, I asked her, that woman was my relative. I said, where is the Qibla? The woman said, Biduni ma taze izdevaj kardim, which means that we got married, it's only 2 months. So I've never prayed in this house. So I don't know where the Qibla is. The situation is such at times that people don't know where the Qibla is at their house. And then we call ourselves the followers of Fatima. We call ourselves the followers of Zahra. Our namaz becomes qada, unfortunately. We don't give priority and preference to ma'naviyat. When we say ma'naviyat, this means ma'naviyat. Then we weep and cry. What do we say? Bachcha hawe haath mathe nikri gaya. We weep and cry. Our children, if we talk about our children become what we are, not what we wish for them. What we are, not what we wish for them. Everybody wishes to have good children and righteous children. But then we don't work for them. We don't pray ourselves. Our namaz becomes qaza. These children, when they look, they learn. Only by looking, they learn. Bibi Zahra alayhi salam, on Friday evenings, she would gather her children. You know, when we pray dua samat, especially in summer, it is said that in Friday evenings, the duas are being accepted. Friday is the Sayyidul Ayyam. It is the leader of the days. It's a special day for the Muslims. Sayyidul Ayyam. On Friday evenings, Zahra alayhi salam would gather her children and she would pray. She would raise her hands and she would say that I'm praying and you say Amin. This is the training from Zahra to her children. If we do so and we help our children in training them in spirituality, they will progress, they will move forward. Provided we help them. It is said about Zahra that on the night of Laylatul Qadr, she would not sleep. She would sprinkle water on Hasanain and Sharifain. And she would tell them that pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a night of prayer. What is all this? This is the training from Zahra. Imam Husayn alayhi salam, on the plains of Karbala. Can you imagine on the plains of Karbala? Well, on that day, when he can see his companions, they are drowned in blood. The corpses are lying on the ground. It was such a sensitive period, such a delicate period, such a crucial period. At that time, Imam Husayn alayhi salam goes to the tent of Imam Sajjad. And what does he say when he hugs his son, Imam Sajjad? He says that, I want to teach you a dua, O my son, which I am taught by my mother Zahra. This dua, I am taught by my mother Zahra. Now imagine, how old was Imam Husayn when Bibi Zahra passed away? He was only 6 years of age. It means he was under six. And this dua was taught to Imam Husayn by his mother Zahra. Yani, see the upbringing of Zahra. To strengthen spirituality. And which dua is that? Imam Husayn says to his son, Imam Sajjad, that, oh my son Sajjad, whenever you are in hum and gham, whenever you are distressed, recite this dua. Bihaqqi Taha wa Yasin, wa bihaqqi al-Qur'an al-Hakim, ya man yaqdiru ala hawaij al-sa'ilin, ya man ya'lamu ma fi al-zamir, ya munaffisa anil makrubin, ya rahim al-shaykh al-kabir, يا رازق الطفل الصغير يا من لا يحتاج إلى التفسير وافعل بي يا الله. And after that, you need to do your hajat. Imam Husayn says that this dua I am taught by my mother Zahra. When did Zahra teach her son? When Imam was six or perhaps lesser than six. The other thing which Imam Husayn says to Imam Sajjad is, he says three things. This one, this dua, at that crucial moment. Another thing, alayka bis sabr. Oh my son, be patient. The third nasiha of Imam Husayn alayhi salam, on that crucial moment was that, oh my son, إِيَّاكَ بِالظُّلْمِ لِمَنْ لَا نَاصِرَ لَهُ. Be careful of that oppression. Do not oppress a person who does not have a supporter. Allah is his supporter. Ek durud bheje Muhammad aur Ali Muhammad par. Agar hum chahte hain ke hum Zahra ke naksh kadam par chalein, agar hum chahte hain dar haqeeqat sahi maano pe Zahra ke pairokar bane, unki pairavi kare, to phir hamare family relations ko mohkam banaye, qawi banaye. Bahut zaruri hai aur bahut muhim hai ke hum mohkam banaye hamare family relations ko. Bahut muhim hai. Kehte hain ke Imam Ali alaihi salam, Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, Imam Ali alayhi salam Nahjul Balagha mein name 28, letter number 28 mein likhte hain. Kya likhte hain? Zahra ki shahad, Imam kehte hain Zahra ki shahadat ke baad Muawiya se, liyal fakhr bi Fatima wa abiha, mujhe fakhr hai. Kya kehte hain? Ke mujhe fakhr hai ke Fatima minna, Fatima sayyidatun nisa'il alamin minna. Dusri cheez, agar hum chahte ke hum hamare relation ko कायम और दायम रखे, तो दूसरी चीज यह है कि हम एक दूसरे को अप्रिशिएट करें, कद्र करें, हमारे घर वालों की कद्र करें. मामूलन क्या होता है कि हम कद्र नहीं करते हैं. एक नेमत जब होती है तो हम कद्र नहीं करते हैं. इस दरमियान में मिसाल के तौर पर अगर हमारे पास अच्छी मस्जिद है, अच्छा इमाम बारगाह है, अच्छी मदरसा है, अच्छे असातीद है, अच्छे लोग हैं, अच्छी जमात है कि नहीं, जो भी आप कहे, ये सब नेमत है. कुछ लोगों के पास ये नेमत नहीं है, लेकिन हम कद्र नहीं करते हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि हमारे पास है. लिहाजा और अगर जो आदमी घर पे कद्र नहीं करता है तो बाहर क्या कद्र करेगा. तो कहने का मकसद ये है कि अपने घर वालों की कद्र करो. सेंस ऑफ एप्रिसिएशन, ये बहुत जरूरी है. इमाम अली अलैहि सलाम ने कद्र की जहरा की. नामे में लिखते हैं कि लियल फख्र बि फातिमा व अबीहा, हमें फख्र है फातिमा पर, फख्र है उनके वाले बुजुर्गवार के ऊपर, फख्र है हमें. या तो इमाम अली अलैहि सलाम जहरा की शहादत के बाद इमाम ने किसी से कहा, इमाम ने क्या कहा कि जहरा ने इतनी जहमत की मेरे घर पे, उन्होंने इतनी चक्की पीस पीस के उनके हाथों पे छाले आ गए थे, इतना काम किया जहरा ने मेरे घर पे. रसूल अल्लाह को आप देखिए, रसूल अल्लाह ने इतनी कद्र की बीवी खदीजतुल कुबरा की कि रसूल अल्लाह, अलबत्ता खदीजा की शहादत के बाद भी रसूल अल्लाह याद किया करते थे खदीजा को और कहते थे ऐना मिसलु खदीजा, खदीजा जैसी औरत कहाँ, खदीजा जैसी मोहतरमा कहाँ, उन्होंने सब कुछ कुर्बान किया इस्लाम के ऊपर. एक शख्स आता है रसूल अल्लाह के पास, और अब बहुत कम मवारिद में देखा जाता है कि लोग कद्र करते हैं अपनी, अपने फैमिली मेम्बर्स को, अपनी अहलिया को. औरत बहुत कम मवारिद में मर्द की कद्र करती है, मर्द भी बहुत कम मवारिद में औरत की कद्र करता है. हालांकि कुरान कहता है कि ये तुम्हारा लिबास है, लिबासुल लकुम व लिबासुल लहुन्ना. लिबास क्या है? उनको प्रोटेक्ट करो, महफूज रखो. एक शख्स आता है रसूल अल्लाह के पास, इंटरेस्टिंग है बहुत ये वाकया, और कहता है रसूल अल्लाह से कि या रसूल अल्लाह, मेरी अहलिया बहुत अच्छी है, कद्र करता है और कहता है कि अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, खुदा ने मुझे बहुत अच्छी अहलिया अता की है. तो हुजूर कहते हैं कि अच्छा बताओ किस लिए तुम कहते हो कि अच्छी है. तो वो कहता है कि या रसूल अल्लाह, जब भी मैं घर में वारिद होता हूं तो वो मेरे लिए दरवाजे को खोलती है, अच्छी तरीके से इस्तकबाल करती है, और जब मैं घर को छोड़ता हूं तो वो एस्कॉर्ट करती है, और जब भी मैं मुश्किल में होता हूं, टेंशन में रहता हूं, तो वो मुझसे कहती है कि किस लिए, क्यों कर तुम टेंशन में हो, क्यों फिक्र करते हो. अगर तुम्हारा फिक्र और तुम्हारे सोच दुनिया के लिए है, पैसे के लिए है, तो मत सोचो, और अगर आखिरत के लिए है तो खुदा तुम्हारी हिदायत करे, और सोचो ताकि गुनाह कम किया जाए. जब रसूल अल्लाह, वो ऐसी औरत नहीं थी कि कहती थी कि भाई अगर वो फिक्र करता है तो भले ज्यादा फिक्र करे, है कि नहीं, गुस्से में नहीं आती थी, बल्कि वो कहते थे कि खुदावंद करीम अगर तुम आखिरत के बारे में सोचते हो तो खुदावंद करीम तुम्हारी हिदायत करे ताकि तुम आखिरत को याद करो। तो उस वक्त हुजूर ने दो चीज़ें बयान की। हुजूर ने फरमाया पहली चीज़ ये है कि मेरा सलाम भेजो, कहो कि रसूल अल्लाह ने तुम्हें सलाम भेजा। दूसरी चीज़ उबशिरहा बिल जन्ना, उनको जन्नत की बशारत दो। तीसरी चीज़ कहो कि खुदावंद करीम के लिए दुनिया में उनके कुछ एजेंट्स होते हैं, आमिलुन, वो खुदा की एजेंट है इस दुनिया में, खुदा की एजेंट है इस दुनिया में। मोहतरम सामीन, तीसरी चीज क्या है? तीसरी चीज अगर हम चाहते हैं कि हमारे फैमिली रिलेशंस को कवी बनाए और मुस्तहकम बनाए, तीसरी चीज ये है कि मोहब्बत, खुद मोहब्बत। तुमने अगर अपनी जोजा से कहा आई लव यू, मैं तुम्हें चाहता हूं, तो इमाम सादिक फरमाते हैं, रसूल भी फरमाते हैं, हुजूर क्या फरमाते हैं? हुजूर फरमाते हैं कि एक स्टेटमेंट जो तुमने अपनी अहलिया से कहा वो स्टेटमेंट हमेशा उनके दिल में रहेगा, कभी भी नहीं निकलेगा। और इमाम सादिक ये भी कहते हैं कि अगर तुमने कहा मैं तुम्हें चाहता हूं, किसी से तुम चाहते और पसंद करते हो तो ऐलान करो, कहो कि मैं तुम्हें चाहता हूं। फकत एक वाक्य और आपकी ज़हमत को तमाम करो। मैंने पहले भी अर्ज किया था कि आज इमाम खुमैनी रहमतुल्लाह अलैह की विलादत की शब भी है ना, रहबर इनकलाब। इमाम खुमैनी के बारे में मिलता है, क्या मिलता है? इमाम खुमैनी के बारे में ये मिलता है कि वो बहुत मुनज्जम थे लेकिन पंक्चुअलिटी के साथ अपने फैमिली रिलेशंस को बहुत मुस्तहकम रखते थे, कवी रखते थे। इतने पंक्चुअल इमाम खुमैनी कि 1:45 वो नहार खाते थे, लंच खाते थे 1:45। 2:00 और जब भी लंच खाते थे तो अपनी अहलिया के साथ, हज खानुम के साथ लंच खाते थे। अगर कोई भी दावत किया करता था तो वो कहते थे मैं नहीं आऊंगा। बड़े बड़े लोग, निजामी लोग, दौलत के लोग, गवर्नमेंट वाले, निजामी खुसूसी के लोग दावत किया करते थे, इमाम खुमैनी इनकार किया करते थे। इमाम कहते थे कि मन बायद बा हम सरम लहर बुखुरम, मैं मेरी अहलिया के साथ लंच खाऊं। आप मुझे माफ कीजिए, एक्सक्यूज मी। लिहाजा इमाम अपने अहलिया के साथ खाना किया करते थे। 1:45 लंच का टाइम था, 2:00 अखबार का टाइम था, अखबार। उसके बाद 1:15 खाना भी उनका जो टाइम था वो 15 मिनट था। 1:15 आराम करते थे, कैलूला। 3:30 पे अगर उठते थे तो वॉक किया करते थे। 9:00 रात, अगर उस वक्त वो नजफ में रहा करते थे, 15 साल तक नजफ में रहा करते थे, 9:00 रात अमीरुल मोमिनीन के हरम में हुआ करते थे, ज़ियारत जामे करीबी, जामे कबीरा पढ़ा करते थे। लोग कहते थे अगर हम इमाम की ज़ियारत के लिए चाहते थे, मुश्ताक होते थे, तो हम अमीरुल मोमिनीन के हरम में जाते थे। 9:00 हम देखते थे कि इमाम खुमैनी वहां पर ज़ियारत जामे कबीरा पढ़ते हैं। और बाज लोग तो अपनी घड़ी को सेट करते थे, इमाम को देखते थे, इमाम खुमैनी इतने मुनज्जम, इतने पंक्चुअल। एक दिन 1:45 का टाइम था वो इमाम खुमैनी कि कितने पंक्चुअल थे। एक दिन उनके गुलाम ने कहा कि खाना रखें हम, तो इमाम ने कहा हज खानुम कुजास्त, मेरी अहलिया कहाँ है? तो उनसे कहा गया कि आपकी अहलिया शहीद बहिश्ती के घर पर गई है। इमाम ने कहा कि मैं खाना नहीं खाऊंगा हत्ता वो आ जाए। आपको पता है, कहते हैं कि 1 घंटा देर हो गई, उनकी वाइफ ने ड्राइवर से कहा कि कॉल बॉक्स में जाओ और फोन करो और कहो कि हम लोग फंस गए ट्रैफिक में, लिहाजा वो खाना खाए, मेरा इंतजार न करे। इमाम खुमैनी ने 1 घंटे तक इंतजार किया। वो तो 1:45 का टाइम था ना, हज खानुम पहुंचती है 2:45 पे। जब 2:45 पे पहुंचती है तो इमाम खुमैनी से पूछती है आपने खाना नहीं खाया, क्यों आप खाना खाते? तो इमाम ने फरमाया इट्स वर्थ इट, इट्स ऑल वर्थ इट टू वेट फॉर यू फॉर एन आवर। वो इमाम जो कितने मुनज्जम थे, बट इट्स ऑल वर्थ इट टू वेट फॉर यू फॉर एन आवर, बट आई सिट विथ यू एंड हैव लंच विथ यू। मोहतरम सामीन, आए हम सब मिलके खुदावंद करीम के पास दुआ करें के पालने वाले भी हक के जाहरा व उम्मीहा व अबीहा व बा अलीहा व बनीहा وَسِرِّ الْمُسْتَوْدِهِ فِيهَا. خدایا ہمارے خانوادے کے ریلیشنز جو ہے, ہمارے خانوادے کے رشتے کو مستحکم محکم کر اور قوی بنا. خدایا ہمارے بچوں کو تو سیدھے راستے پر رکھ. یہ قرآن کی آیت ہے اور بہت مہم دعا ہے اور دعا بھی ہے. ربنا حب لنا من ازواجنا وذریاتنا قرۃ اعین وجعلنا للمتقین اماما. جو چاہتے ہیں کہ ان کو اولاد صالح عطا ہو, جو چاہتے ہیں کہ ان کو نیک عورتیں ملے اور نیک اہلیہ ملے, تو وہ یہ دعا کرے. ربنا حب لنا, سورہ فرقان کی آیت ہے, چپٹر 25 ورس نمبر 74. ربنا حب لنا من ازواجنا وذریاتنا قرۃ اعین. یہاں تک ملتا ہے روایت میں کہ جس کے گھر میں اچھے ریلیشن نہ ہو تو وہ یہ آیت کی تلاوت کرے, ریلیشنز اچھے ہو جائیں گے. پالنے والے ہمارے بچے اور ہمارے جوانان کو سیدھے راستے پر رکھ. خدایا ہم سب جانتے ہیں کہ ائمہ بقی میں, جہاں پہ ہمارے بقی اور بعض روایت میں ملتا ہے کہ ہماری بیوی زہر مرضیہ وہاں پہ مدفون ہے, خدایا جنت البقی کی جلد از جلد تعمیر ہو جائے. پالنے والے تجھے واسطہ دیتے ہیں زہرہ کا, ان کے والد بزرگوار, ان کے بچوں کا, ان کے بالحا, ان کے شوہر امیر المومنین کا واسطہ دیتے ہیں. اگر زندگی دیتا ہے تو محمد اور آل محمد کی محبت اور مودت میں زندگی عطا کر. اگر موت دیتا ہے تو محمد اور آل محمد کی محبت اور مودت میں موت عطا کر. خدایا ہمارے مریضوں کو تو شفا تو کامل و عاجل عطا فرما, مخصوصاً سجاد کریم, عمار حاجی, محمد کمیل اور تمام مومنین المومنات جو مریض ہیں ہماری جماعت میں, دوسری جگہ میں, دیگر جماعت میں, خدایا ان کو تو جلد از جلد شفا تو کامل و عاجل عطا فرما. اکبر بھائی صبور, عبد البھائی صبور, ان کو بھی شفا تو کامل و عاجل عطا فرما. پالنے والے تجھے واسطہ دیتے ہیں محمد اور آل محمد کا, جو مقروض ہے ان کا قرض غیب سے ادا کرنا, جو بے اولاد ہیں ان کو تو اولاد صالح عطا کر. خدایا جن ممالک میں امن و امان نہیں ہے ان ممالک میں امن و امان قائم کر. رسول کا آخری جانشین جو پردے غیب میں ہے ان کی ظہور میں تو تعجیل فرما, ان کی ظہور میں تو آسانی فرما. افضل السلام بر محمد و آل محمد.
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. مائی ڈیئر اسکالرز, ایلڈرز, برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز, السلام علیکم. فرسٹ آف آل آئی وڈ لائک ٹو وش یو آل خوشحالی مبارک آن دا برتھ اینیورسری آف دا لیڈی آف لائٹ, لیڈی زہرا علیہ السلام. ویل اسٹارٹ آف ود دا کوشچنز. Please forgive me, I'm really bad with names, so I'll just start with the questions. Which scholar shares the same birthday with Bibi Fatima alayhi salam? Now I want some new hands up, please. Let's see. Wow, a lot of choice. The young man right at the back, sitting near the kitchen door. Yes, you.